One morning, Michael went in for his regular dental checkup, expecting nothing out of the ordinary. To his surprise, his trusted dentist, Dr. Robinson, informed him that he had gingivitis. He was shocked. While he did not know much about it, it sounded serious. He immediately asked, "I didn't notice anything wrong. Should I be worried?" Dr. Robinson replied, saying, "Don't worry. Gingivitis is surprisingly common and completely reversible. Let me tell you more about it and why it is important to address it." Gingivitis refers to the early stages of gum disease. It is caused by a buildup of bacteria and other particles on the surface of your teeth, creating a sticky film known as plaque. If not removed, the plaque hardens over time. This hardened layer leaves the gums prone to bacterial infection. Gingivitis results in symptoms like bad breath, swollen tender gums, loose teeth, and receding gums, or longer appearing teeth. If left untreated, it can progress into a more severe form of gum disease called periodontitis, where the gum line recedes, teeth may fall out, and supporting bone may be lost. There are also some risk factors involved in developing gingivitis. Smoking, diabetes, and even your genetics can make you susceptible. Research also shows that socioeconomic barriers make it more difficult to care for oral health. Having a low toothbrushing frequency on average, as well as lower access to oral health tools and education, contribute to a high prevalence of gingivitis. It is important to take action at the gingivitis stage, as this is the only stage of gum disease that is reversible. So how exactly do you know if you have gingivitis? The first step to diagnosing gingivitis is paying a visit to your dentist or dental hygienist. They have the necessary experience and expertise to examine your gums. For instance, let's take a closer look at how Dr. Robinson would diagnose gingivitis in her patient, Michael. Dr. Robinson will make sure to ask Michael whether he has been experiencing any symptoms related to the condition, including whether his gums feel tender or puffy, or bleed easily when he brushes his teeth. Then, Dr. Robinson will take a closer look into Michael's mouth. One method that she may use to do this is called gum probing. This is a relatively painless method in which dentists use a tiny ruler called a probe to check for and measure any pockets around the teeth. In a healthy mouth, the depth of these pockets is usually between 1 and 3 millimeters. Larger pockets of 5 millimeters or greater may indicate progression into gum disease. Another method is utilizing x-ray machines to check how much jawbone a patient has surrounding each tooth. The bone is what keeps your tooth secure, and so it is important to identify if any bone loss has occurred. Oral health professionals will also make sure to ask about your medical history in order to identify risk factors you may have to developing gingivitis and potential gum disease. Once Dr. Robinson has finished assessing Michael, she considers whether she should refer him to a periodontist. Periodontists are experts in the diagnosis and treatment of gum disease and may provide you with treatment options that are not offered by your dentist. Ultimately, she decides that Michael's gingivitis has not progressed enough to refer him. If Michael is diagnosed with gingivitis, Dr. Robinson would focus on providing treatments that reverse the symptoms of the condition. Scaling is a process in which plaque and tartar are removed. Root planing is a process that removes the bacteria that causes the inflammation and smooths root surfaces to prevent further buildup of tartar and bacteria. Dr. Robinson explains that after getting his teeth professionally cleaned, it is imperative that Michael makes changes at home to prevent further gum disease. She recommends that he is brushing his teeth twice a day and flossing every day. Dr. Robinson also emphasizes to Michael that if he smokes, stopping smoking will prevent the progression of gingivitis. While these are treatments that Dr. Robinson saw fit for Michael, make sure to talk to your dentist about what treatment is best for you. Now for some frequently asked questions. Meet Dr. Ruhee Jaffer. She's a practicing general and cosmetic dentist in the LA DC area. She is here to help answer some common questions towards oral health. What are some of the common signs of gum disease?
Signs of gum disease are like inflammation anywhere else. So you get, you know, bleeding, you get puffy gums, you get sometimes pain on, you know, brushing or flossing. You start getting what we call pocketing. So because the gums are more inflamed, when we use our periodontal probe to measure it, it starts, you know, the pockets start getting deeper than 3 millimeters. So that's where your hygienist or your dentist will usually measure the pockets in your mouth, because we want to make sure that the gums are nice and tight. So a sign of healthy gums would be firm, pink, stippled gingiva without that puffy factor. And the margins should not look rolled like tires or rounded. That when you start seeing signs of that, it means that the bacteria is starting to sit under the gum line and, you know, cause a little bit of destruction.
How often do you notice patients with gingivitis? And do you bring it up with the patients every time you encounter it?
Yes, I do bring it up every time I encounter it because it's totally preventable. So a lot of diseases in the mouth, like either gingivitis or cavities, are prevented with proper oral hygiene care, assuming that there's no other things going on, like depending on the type of medication someone is or the other medical conditions they have. But because it's very easy to prevent, it's something that we always touch on. And so prevention includes things like flossing, brushing well, adjunct aids like mouthwashes or different types of toothpaste can definitely keep things under control a little bit. Gingivitis is actually a reversible disease. Once it progresses past a certain point, it becomes what we call periodontitis. And what periodontitis is, it really is a fancy Latin word, which means perio, gum, odonto is a root for bone, and itis is inflammation. So periodontitis is once the inflammation becomes so bad in gingivitis, you start getting bone loss. And once it reaches that stage, it's irreversible. So what you can do is maintain it, but we try to always catch our patients before it becomes periodontal disease, because ultimately the consequence of severe periodontal disease is that you lose teeth. And when people lose teeth, they lose a lot of form and function. And you know, we use our mouths a lot, so it really does affect quality of life.
Why is there a saying that gingivitis is the gateway to other oral health concerns?
When I like to talk about the mouth, I always say it's really just the beginning of your GI, and this is either you're breathing things in or you're eating things in. It really is the gateway to a lot of other things. So bacteria in your mouth, unfortunately, don't stay in your mouth. They start to spread everywhere else. And if we know that plaque and films of bacteria are rampantly colonizing every 12 to 24 hours, they're like multiplying in size. After the mouth, they have to go somewhere else. So that's where you start getting all these other oral systemic things. So you get a lot of inflammatory proteins that, you know, cause things like arteriosclerosis or in pregnant women, preterm births and low birth weights, or stroke, because inflammatory proteins don't just, if it's inflammation in your mouth, it's not just staying in your mouth, it starts to affect other parts of your body. And I hate to say this, but a lot of diseases have their first manifestations in the oral cavity. So things like, you know, even COVID had some oral manifestations, which is the most recent example. But when people have diabetes, you see definitely changes in the microvasculature in the mouth. In patients who are immunocompromised and may have either like other things going on, you often see ulcerations or lesions in the mouth that depict the systemic condition. So, I mean, there's a lot you can tell by looking at a mouth because of how the mucosa is in the mouth. And so it's really interesting. It's just a part of the body and vice versa.
Thank you to Dr. Ruhee Jaffer for answering our questions. We hope you have a better understanding of gingivitis. Thank you for watching.